Good evening, pipe smokers. Welcome back at the green table. As you see, I'm not at home, so I have to use this improvised green table. I hope you can live with this change of pace. So, gentlemen, recently I was strolling to town looking for interesting pipes to find, and I visited an antiquary and I found these two older beauties. So, my piña colada, excuse me. Since you know, I love collecting American pipes, I love to collect American pipes, sorry. And here we have a Medico Jetstream, and here we have an E.A.Carey Magic Inch patent pipe. So, as you see, the Medico Jetstream, it has some strange coating inside, but it is unsmoked. It is stamped Select Briar. It's rather dark. It looks as if it had some wear. It was surely lying at the tobacconist for some time. It has Jetstream in white on the stem, and it still has the original sticker. Guaranteed nylon bit bite proof. For one thing, it's good that it's nylon, so it is not oxidized, as the older vulcanite stems are, so I don't have to clean anything. On the other hand, bite-proof, we all know that nylon isn't the best material to use for a bit because it quickly gets tooth marks compared to acrylic. The grain is okay, I would say. Nothing special, but on the first glance I can see no fills. This is a pipe with a tiny volume. Haven't smoked it yet, so I can't tell you anything. Maybe more interesting is the E.A.Carey pipe. I quickly looked them up in the internet and the company still exists and they still do make pipes. And they still do make these magic inch pipes. And I have no clue how any of these pipes made its way to Austria. Because I've never seen Medico or Carey pipes for sale anywhere. And the funny thing is, Dwight from the Pipe Smoking Laugh Maker channel recently purchased such a pipe and did show it on his channel. And a few days later, I found exactly the same pipe in Austria, of all places. So, as you see, the pipe has been smoked. It has been smoked a lot. There's a dark charring on the rim, and maybe I'm going to sand it off. Sandblasted finish, which is now has become very smooth over the years. So I guess this pipe saw a lot and was used a lot. Lucky enough, the bit is also some kind of plastic, nylon probably, so I just had to clean it a little up, and it looks really nice. So no oxidation. So gentlemen, I will pause this video to disassemble these pipes so I can show you more of the patent part of this pipe. So here I'm back again with the disassembled pipes. As you see, the Medico pipe has a 6mm filter, which was the intention of the Medico brand to sell the fitting Medico filters. You know, it's a sub-brand of K-Woody. Yeah, a metal bit, which is not the best solution because it easily can damage the shank of the briar. Anyway, more interesting is the E.A.Carey pipe with the magic inch. As you see, there are ventilation slits in the mouthpiece. Here should be the E.A.Carey logo in white, but it has gone off over the years. Here you have this part. This one sticks into the briar. This part has ventilation holes. And this pipe only works well if you put this paper sleeve sold and produced by E.A.Carey over it. This blocks the ventilation holes, the ventilation slits, and then this pipe can be smoked. I don't know how it smokes without it. Maybe you have to close the slits with your fingers while smoking. Or as Dwight did, he taped it so he can smoke the pipe, but I guess he is missing this part. I have smoked this pipe once with the only sleeve that I have. This one was already attached and has already been used, and it smoked surprisingly dry. Maybe this is because of the very old briar. Maybe this system works. I can't tell you how this should actually have any effect on the smoke, but maybe I'm wrong. I will also look if I can find a substitute for this paper sleeves. I don't know if they are available in old Europe. But yeah, there might be a solution to be found. Also have to rim this pipe and sand off the rim. And just one more thing I would like to show to you is this one here. Sorry, lads. This is a Prince Amled pipe. As you see, it has been smoked a lot. Very slim and elegant pipe. It has a wooden stem and a horn bit. But I think this is a replacement stem to the original vulcanite stem because the pipe has been smoked a lot, but the horn bit shows no signs of wear. As you know, horn bits are easily damaged and quickly show tooth marks. This one has none of it. There's also this chain that leads to nowhere. I don't know what has been attached here. Maybe a lid for the pipe. This would, yeah, would fit. But I think this part belonged to a different pipe and just was attached here. And as you see, the pipe is broken. Here, it's just a matter of time till this part is going off. I'll have to figure out a way to fix this. Do you think I shall super glue it? Maybe I give it to some guy who has more experience with pipe repairs. Maybe you can put a metal ring on it. I don't know, it would be a pity if this pipe wouldn't be smokable. It's such an elegant and original piece. Also, Prince Amled pipes seem to be very rare and hard to find, especially with such a shank or bit. Yeah, let's see what I do with this. I bought these pipes all for very, very little money, and I just had to take this one with me. So, guys, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's episode. If you haven't checked out Dwight's channel, the Pipe Smoking Knife Maker, I will put a link below. Please do so. Now, going on with my piña colada. Cheers, gentlemen.